kasama natin ang two young rising stars na siguradong magpapakilig sa atin sa darating na holiday season. Dahil sila ay bibida sa Metro Manila Film Festival entry na The Boy Foretold by the Stars. Kaya naman, please welcome Adrian Lindayag and Kian Johnson. Hi guys! Welcome to Push Pets Live!
Hi guys!
First of all, kamusta naman kayo? Kamusta kayo, Adrian?
Okay naman po. Busy with the promos and guest things for MMFM.
Yes. Kian, how are you?
Ayun po, same din. Been very busy with the promos and balancing it with work and studies as well. But all in all, very happy for this month.
Wow, very productive. The holidays are just around the corner. May mga plans na ba kayo ngayong Pasko?
Manonood ng pelikula. Manonood ng Boy Foretold. Yan talaga ang agenda namin ngayong December 25.
Yes, of course. May mga Christmas traditions ba kayo na ginagawa every year?
Usually, celebrated with my grandparents, tapos mga extended relatives, mga tita. Pero this year, dahil nga hindi pwede ang large gatherings, dito lang kami sa bahay. Dito lang kami sa sala, tapos manonood nitong pelikula. Yun.
Yes. Wow, very supportive talaga ang family ni Adrian, di ba? Ito, panonoodin nyo. Ito, The Boy Foretold, di ba? What about you, Kian?
I'm finally not working on that day. So I get the time to spend it with my family and ang plano namin, we're gonna have a small gathering of just us and my family. We're gonna eat, exchange gifts. Ma-feel ko naman for once na yung Christmas spirit bilang lagi ako nag-work.
What about for the new year? Meron ba kayong mga plano na?
Sa bahay lang. Sana sa beach usually sa beach kami mag-year pero lang hindi pa nga pwede now.
Mm-hmm, yes.
Bahay mo na lang muna. Baka panoorin namin ulit yung pelikula since it's streaming till January 7.
So. Yes, why not, diba? What about you, Kian?
Same. I'm actually spending most of it sa bahay din. Take this time during the pandemic to rest and relax with my family. Yan.
At syempre, New Year eh. Meron ba kayong mga New Year's resolutions? Gumagawa po ba kayo nung ngayon?
My New Year's resolution is as same as almost every year. I aim to become a better version of myself, whether it's personality-wise or work-wise, study-wise. Of course, all of us, we want to become a better person. Siguro I'll focus on my body and mind. And majority of it will be focused on my family as well. Bilang, you never know what will happen. So I want to make every moment of my family count and spend every second of every minute of every day with them.
That's true. That's very, very true. What about you, Adrian?
Same. Actually, nakarelate ako dun kay Kian na every new year, you set goals. You set a different goal. And if you don't get to realize that the year before, you get another chance, a fresh start each new year. Let's create new goals, siguro, bagong mga financial goals, bagong mga fitness goals, and new career goals, bagong projects, bagong roles, na bagong challenges na iti-take on natin for the next year.
Yes, amen to that. Let's claim good things to come sa 2021, di ba? Yes. At syempre, ngayon darating na Kapaskuhan, ipapalabas ang inyong MMFF entry film na The Boy Foretold by the Stars. Pwede nyo bang i-share kung tungkol saan ang movie na ito?
The movie is about two high school boys who meet each other sa isang school retreat. And itong school nila ay exclusive all-boys school. First time nila magkakilala sa retreat na to. Umikot ang kwento sa isang hula. So, hinulaan yung character ko, si Dominic. Hinulaan siya ng isang manghuhula played by Mama Iya Mina, si Mamu. At sabi niya na mamimit ko daw ang soulmate ko sa retreat na yun. Wow. Yun nga, doon ko makikilala yung character ni Kia na si Luke.
What about you, Kian? Ano ba yung mga roles niyo dito? Ikaw ba, Kian? Let's start with you.
My role here with Luke. Luke is a very introverted, athletic introverted high school student. Luke kasi is a straight guy, and he will come up into hurdles in his life, and there will be a moment that he will try to find himself. So that's where he tries to join a retreat. And in this retreat is where he meets his future best friend, si Dominic.
Oh, Dominic, which is you, Adrian. Can you describe your character here?
The character ko po dito is a high school student who's very ambitious. He's almost uptight. And he's clear with his goals. Achiever siya, mataas ang grade niya. He's a student leader. Hindi siya naniniwala sa hula, basically. Kasi nga, logical siya. Siyempre, for people na nagre-rely sa science, it's hard na maniwala sa mga ganitong mga bagay, mga hula, mga tarot cards, mga astrology. Pero bilang nga, nakilala niya si Luke, parang magbabago lahat ng pinaniniwalaan ito.
Wow! So ayun ang kailangan abangan. Paano ba, 'di ba, magde-develop sila dalawa? For you, Kian, how did you feel when you got this role?
When I was approached about this role, I went through the normal process of the audition. But alam ko, if I'm correct, they were sort of short on time na, and imbis na I had to actually go to the audition, I had to kind of slice myself in yung sa schedule nila dire, kasi I know they were busy din, pati rin si Adrian, kasi he also had kadena ng ginto that time. So I was at a get together with my fans. I was celebrating my birthday, and my manager approached me about this role. He told me that it was a BL movie, and that the description fits mine. So I was like, okay, sige, I'll excuse myself from my fans and then I'll pass by. I went there. That's where I met Direct Dolly, and that's where I met Adrian again, because we worked on a previous project beforehand. And that's where he gave me the rundown of the whole story. He told me na it's, again, a BL film, and there's going to be a little bit of intimacy, and if I'm okay with it, if I'm comfortable with it. And without hesitation, I said yes, I'm comfortable with it, because hearing the story, I fell in love with it, and I saw that there was really good potential in this movie. So I decided na yes, I'll do it. And I was crossing my fingers, hoping na Direk Dolly would choose me. And like a few days later, that's where I got the message na I was chosen for the lead role, and I was partnered with Adrian. So when I found out, I was so happy, because this is the first time I get to ever support the LGBTQ plus community. And my mom was proud of me, my friends were proud of me, and I felt so joyful knowing that I was able to push my career at the same time, do it with a sense of advocacy.
Wow, that's really good to hear, Kian, ano, na this is also important to you, na gumanap ka dito sa pelikulang ito. For Adrian naman, of course, ay yun nga, nabanggit niya kanina na you were doing Kadena ng Ginto before, diba? So, kilala na natin si Adrian sa mga roles na ginagawa niya sa ABS noon. But according to your social media, you express yourself as an androfemme. Para sa mga hindi pa familiar masyado sa term na ito, can you explain this to them briefly?
Actually, that's I came across the term androfemme randomly sa internet, and it just nag-resonate siya sa akin. Kasi sa gender expression, merong masculine and feminine. Those are two different types of spectrum. And in the middle, right in the middle, is androgyny. And dito sa androgyny, nag-blur yung lines between masculine traits and feminine traits. Nag-resonate yung androfemme because I have more feminine qualities. But at the same time, I also acknowledge my masculine traits and qualities. And I think it's, loving yourself, because I have the best of both worlds, I think.
Kung i-describe mo ba yung role mo, ganito ba we're going to see this side of you in this film? Or gaano ba kaiba o kapareho yung role mo from Adrian in real life?
I wouldn't say androfemme si Dominic. una sa lahat, I think he's too young to identify himself as such. Ang dami pa niyang kailangan ma-realize tungkol sa sarili niya at pagdaanan bago niya ma-identify yung sarili niya na gano'n. But what I can say is kung gano'n kami kapareho, we are both ambitious, we are both clear with what we want in life.
How was it naman working with each other, kayo ni Kian?
Na-appreciate ko kasi yung how meaningful this project is for Kian. Yung respect na binibigay niya sa akin at sa mga tao sa community namin. Kaya hindi naging mahirap yung connection namin.
Yes, at for sure makikita natin itong chemistry, diba, sa pelikula mismo. What about you, Kian? How would you describe naman working with Adrian?
Working with Adrian was a great experience. I could tell talaga na he was a very passionate person with everything he does. And when I was able to work with him in the Boy for Told by the Stars, talagang na-prove niya talaga na he's professional in every way. But at the same time, he's fun to be with as a friend. He's very supportive, such a loving person. It was easy trying to establish a connection with him. So when we were trying to create chemistry with each other, I wasn't having a hard time. There was no awkward moments. Talagang he's a great person overall. That's the best way I can... I think there's an even better way. But as of now, that's the best way I can put it.
Yes. For Adrian naman, ato ha, tatanungin lang namin yung opinion mo about this. Writer Juan Miguel Severo mentioned before that casting people for boys' love genre is a bit difficult dahil sa systemic homophobia kung saan may fear ang queer actors to portray gay roles. Dahil number one, they're not comfortable talking about their soji. And number two, they're worried na makahon sila sa token gay best friend role and they won't get cast for other parts anymore. Personally, na-experience mo rin ba ito o nagkaroon ka rin ba ng ganitong feeling? Ano ba?
Siguro at the early stages of my career, nung nasa kabilang network pa ako and I was trying out as a singer, I was a teenager and hindi ako pwede mag-out. Naramdaman ko yun, yung parang limitado ka dahil nga sa, parang hindi ka pwede, dahil nga hindi ka pwede mag-out daw. But when I tried showbiz for the second time, nung sumali ako sa cast ng Kadenang Ginto, naging out na ako, naging open na ako sa realidad ko, sa truth ko, my soji. Kasi out naman ako sa pamilya ko, tanggap ako ng pamilya ko. So I said, what's wrong with being truthful with who you are? But I do understand where Gege is coming from. It's a sad reality sa industry natin, but ako, because it's one of my advocacies as an actor, to create queer characters, to keep on portraying queer characters, keep on portraying LGBT characters, at iangat at mag-contribute sa pagbibigay ng dangal at dignidad sa community natin. And I don't mind being stereotyped or being typecast sa mga gay characters. I don't mind at all. Siguro responsibilidad ko na yun kung paano ko ipoportray yung mga characters na ito na hindi lang sila pang comedic relief. And also, this is a call na may mga aktor na may kakayahan na mag-portray ng mga characters na hindi lang pang comedy, na pwede sila sa love story, pwede sila sa iba't pang mga genre tulad ng horror, pwede sa heavy drama. So, ayun, it's a call for producers and writers and directors na meron po tayong mga LGBT actors na pwede nating bigyan ng trabaho at ng mga proyekto at gagampanan nila yung mga roles na yun ng 101%.
Wow! Very well said, Adrian. Kung may mensahe ka ngayon, how will you encourage other actors to be open to accepting queer roles?
Una sa lahat, wala ako sa posisyon para hikayatin ng iba na mag-out kasi everyone has their own journey, everyone has their own timeline, and kung ready ka na, ready ka na. Kung hindi pa, we respect that. But this is more of an encouragement sa industriya natin na mas maging open tayo sa pagcast ng real LGBT actors, real LGBT people sa mga LGBT characters, sa mga LGBT roles. Kasi limitado na nga yung mga roles na ganito, ipagdadamot pa natin sa mga tunay na nangangailangan ng ganitong roles or ng ganitong trabaho. So sana ibigay na natin sa mga nangangailangan ng trabaho para, you know, meron namang mga straight characters dyan. Yung mga straight na actors, dun yun na nailagay. Kasi marami naman straight characters. Yun lang naman ay sa akin.
Yes, and I agree. Wow, that's a really wonderful perspective, Adrian. And thank you for sharing that. For Kia naman, ano naman ang natutunan mo from your role sa film na to?
What I learned from this role and throughout this whole movie, which I kind of learned then before I actually did this project, was na, and isa pa to na I always learned from Adrian, is na love knows no gender. And that no one can tell you who you should or shouldn't love. At this point of age, na people have to be open to new possibilities, not be closed down to what is or what isn't. And I think that this movie has an incredible way of portraying that. And I really encourage you all to watch it and experience the, how do you put this, the roller coaster of emotions that Luke has gone through throughout this whole movie.
Yes, and finally, ano sa tingin niyo magiging takeaway ng viewers and fans from this movie pag napanood na nila ito?
Ako, yung mismo, yung sinabi ni Kian, sabi niya, love knows no gender. I think that's the most important message na makukuha nila after seeing this film. Kasi nga, it's a love story. Everyone's saying that the story is new because there are two boys who fall in love with each other. But you will be surprised how familiar it is, how it's just the same love for everyone. It's just like watching a normal rom-com, a usual rom-com, rather.
Yes, at talaga nga naman, very exciting itong pelikula na to na aabangan yan ng mga Pushmates natin. Thank you so much guys for being very insightful about these questions, diba, sa mga sagot ninyo. Ngayon naman, let's play the game called Put the Finger Down Challenge. So, simple lang ang mechanics dito. First, just put all your 10 fingers up and then put the finger down if nagawa or na-experience nyo na ang mga bagay na sasabihin ko. Put the finger down if been caught in unrequited love. Experience nyo na ba yan? Oh, si Adrian, experience nyo na. And Kian also. Okay, unrequited love. Wait lang guys, curious na ako, how would you describe an unrequited love? Para sa inyo, ano yung unrequited love?
Pag minahal mo siya, tas hindi ka niya minahal pabalik.
Oh, that's unrequited love for Adrian. What about you, Kian?
Actually the same way. That's sort of exactly the same experience I had to go through.
Oh! Same experience daw. Meron talagang hugot nito si Kian, di ba? Yes. Oh, number two. Try dating apps. Try dating apps. Adrian, tried. Yes, Kian, ikaw din ba?
No, I haven't.
Oh, no, haven't. Okay. Next, drunk called or texted the person you like. Oh, pag ganyan ba?
I will not lie. Fine.
Pag ganyan ba guys, talaga bang drunk kayo nung nangyari yun? Or may pagka sinasadya ng konti?
Kasi may regrets eh. May regret after. So, definitely not in the right mind.
Oh yeah, oh, yun lang, di ba? Yes. Number four, nakaalitan ang co-star.
No.
Yes. Adrian, wala pa
rin. Wala din.
Yes. Number five, naging interested or nagka-crush sa co-star nyo? Oh.
Lahat naman yata. Piling ko lahat naman tayo na experience yan.
Lalo na pag malakas ang chemistry ba? Ganun ba yun?
Oo, hindi. Tsaka, syempre yung industriya natin punong-puno ng mga beautiful faces.
So, you meet new people you can't help but like try to assess their personality and see if it suits yours.
Yes, that's true. Eto naman, na-insecure about sa isang bagay sa sarili mo. Ay, na-insecure, of course. I mean, okay, Adrian and okay, Kian. Usually ba, how do you like fight off insecurities? Kung kunyari napifeel yun eh, insecure kayo. How do you motivate yourself?
Inaalala ko lang na hindi ka pwedeng nagko-compare ng sarili mo sa iba. Kasi may sarili kang journey, may sarili kang timeline. And you have to constantly make yourself a better version of yourself. Ganyan. So, huwag mong ikumpara yung sarili mo sa iba. Ikumpara mo yung sarili mo sa kung sino ka kahapon.
Oh, yes. Yeah. What about you, Kian?
I totally agree with Adrian. It's actually very well said. Ako naman, when I deal with my insecurities, I take my insecurities and turn it into something positive. It's a way of being able to mend myself to become, like Adrian said, a better person or better version of yourself. Like, for example, if people say na I'm a little bit too chubby or whatnot, of course, I'll try to fix that insecurity of mine and make it better.
Ayun, that's another way of looking at that, diba? Eto naman, nag-ghost ka na. Nag-ghost ka na. Oh, si Adrian. And ikaw ba, Kian? Oh, yes. Oh. Eh, ito naman, nang-ghost ka. Ikaw ang nang-ghost. Oh, Kian.
Nahawa.
Ikaw din, Adrian. Oh!
Dapat hindi na nangyayari yan. Pero guilty ako nung mas bata-bata pa ako. But I think it's a bad personality trait or a bad cultural whatever of our generation. Sa generation natin yan eh. I don't know why.
Yeah. But yun nga, di ba? Noon lang naman yun, di ba? For you, noon lang naman. I mean, nagmamature naman din ang mga tao, di ba? Eto naman, nagpahula tungkol sa iyong future. Nagpahula na ba? Okay yan! Si ABN, ikaw ba nagpahula na? Hindi pa?
Di ba nakakatawa that this movie is about hula? Pero ako never pa ako nagpahula in my life.
Pero ito ha, kasi
pero
ito si...
I'm open to
it. Oh, yes. Eh, ito kasi si Kian, sabi niya nagpahula na siya. Ikaw, Kian, okay lang sa'yo, naniniwala ka sa hula.
In some aspects, yes, medyo naniniwala ako. Dalawang beses na po kasi ako nagpahula. And in those two times, medyo spot on po yung hula nila sa akin. So, there's this little part of me that believes then na it could be real. Of course, you know, you still can't help but try to contradict it. Pero as of now, medyo onti lang.
Oh, eto naman, last na lang. Nagkagusto, naging interested sa straight. For Adrian pala to, for Adrian. Nagkagusto, naging interested sa straight.
Interested lang naman, so okay.
Okay, masyado mabigat yung word na nagkagusto na. Interested pa lang, yes.
Interested lang naman. I don't usually pursue or acknowledge my feelings pagka ganon. Kasi masasaktan lang ako eh.
Oh!
Ako eh. So siya. Alam ko pagka girl yung gusto niya. Okay, bye.
Oh. Ayun. Ito naman, for Kian naman. Nagkagusto, naging interested sa gay or bi?
Yeah, meron isa sa bi. And you can't, sorry, I'm gonna bring my finger down now. You can't, sa totoo lang, and I don't really have that toxic masculinity thing in mind. There are times naman I see men as attractive din naman. Because of course, you can't help na kaya nga, let's say for example, guwapo sila, maganda buhok nila, maganda yung katawan. You can't help but think na they look attractive. Pero hindi naman to the point na nagkagusto ako. And then, yung gusto naman, nagkagusto ako sa isang bae.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. So, bali dalawa. Meron silang dalawang fingers na tira. Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for joining us here tonight. And before we let you go, please invite our Pushmates to support your upcoming film.
Iniimbitahan po namin kayo na nanonood ngayon na piliin, unahin ang The Boy Foretold by the Stars sa MMFF 2020 po yan. And it's streaming worldwide via upstream.ph simula December 25, sa araw ng Pasko.
Yes, guys, don't forget, you guys can also start reserving your tickets now. And for our fellow Filipinos abroad, you guys can start reserving your tickets on December 18. And for more updates, please don't forget to follow our social media accounts and the social media account of The Boy Foretold by the Stars. Yes, we have Facebook and Twitter. And don't forget to use our official hashtag, #MMFF on Upstream and
Love wins this Christmas.
Thank you so much, Adrian and Kian. That's it, Pushmates. We hope you enjoyed our chikahan tonight. Don't forget to like, follow, and subscribe to our social media pages for updates. Once again, this is Gary with Adrian Lindayak and Kian Johnson. And this is Push Bets Live.